on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. What's up, my feast jars? Oh, what? Hey, what's up? It's your girl, Vinay, your life and dating coach. How's it going? It's hot. Sporting the tank top. It's really hot in the Bay Area. I'm trying to keep cool. Keep it cool. I have a skylight. It's not really helping with the warm weather. Nope. But anyways, hey, so I'm going to do this episode on on-off relationships because it's very, very much a topic that's been requested, especially from the Lady V-Star, so this one's for you. Let's do this! You've had an on-off relationship. Maybe you're dealing with one right now. I believe that if you break up more than twice, most likely it's not meant to be. If you're in an on-off relationship, take the time to really think about, do you really want to get back with this person? Was this a good relationship? Was it healthy? What's the reasons for you guys are breaking up? And do you want to continue this? The last reason that you want to be in a relationship is because afraid of being single, the unknown, or worried that you're never going to feel this way towards someone else again, or that you won't feel so comfortable around someone like this. Trust me, it just gets better along the way, okay? Just think of it as you're at the very beginning of the dating road. So along this road, you're going to meet different people and you're going to have different experiences. Never think that this is the end for you, that you're never going to find someone better. Instead, take this time for yourself. I find that oftentimes people who are in these on-off relationships tend to lose themselves. They lose their identity because their whole life evolved around this person, or either it was an unhealthy relationship. Take the time to reflect, what did you learn from this relationship? What did you gain about yourself? What it is that you want and you need? But most importantly, finding that balance for yourself so that you don't feel like you always have to be in a relationship. So that you don't always feel like you have to depend on somebody. For the most part, if it's an on-off relationship and you guys broken up like a few times, most likely it's probably not going to work out. And that's okay. And it's something that you may have to accept, right? Because you want to move on, especially for yourself, is that you are happy. You know, you don't feel like you always have to chase this person, chase this person's acceptance, or, you know, trying so hard to make this work. I think that true love and a good, healthy relationship, it isn't all that complicated. It doesn't have to take so much work that you, like, lose yourself. Remember that only at the beginning of this road, okay, it's not the end. You're going to meet some great people along the way. Don't you deserve to be in a happy relationship? Don't you deserve to be happy? I believe in that. Hard as it may be, take this time for yourself. Really learn more about yourself, do meditation, read, find balance, spend time with friends, build that relationship and friendships that you may have lost in this on-off relationship, because the most important thing is your balance, your sanity, and your happiness. The star of the week is Camellia. Find out why at Vinay.com. You're afraid that you'll never find someone. Ugh, fuckballs.